everyone. As you can probably tell by the title, this is going to be my everyday flawless foundation routine. So I really do like a full coverage, flawless matte finish for my foundation. I do wear this every day. I'm not into natural finishes, so if you do like natural or light coverage foundation, this video is not for you, so don't feel the need to comment down below and tell me that it's too heavy or whatever. As you'll see later on in the video, my skin is not flawless without foundation, so I do try to make up for it with foundation. This is pretty much my everyday makeup routine video as well, because I don't really tend to wear eyeshadow if I'm just going out during the day, or I don't have one particular look that I always tend to lean towards. So yeah, this is pretty much my makeup routine, my foundation routine, and my eyebrow routine all in one little video. So I hope you enjoy! Okay, so this is my face without makeup. I know I look quite different without makeup, but to be honest, a lot of people do, most people do. Makeup is an amazing thing and it works wonders, but it does make us look quite a bit different. So yeah, at the moment I do look quite different just because I'm always fake tanned and my face will always be whiter than the rest of my body because I am naturally white as snow. I've also got a lot of like redness and breaking out quite a bit recently, so that should be gone soon, but it's just a factor at the moment, so that's lovely. Also, I look really different without mascara on because you guys know that I always go all out with my mascara because I have long lashes, so when I don't wear it, my face looks really weird and like I've got little tiny bug eyes or something like that. So yeah, I'm also sick at the moment if you can't already tell by my voice. So I've been having trouble sleeping at night, so my face is just a bit of a bleh at the moment, so be nice.
I forgot to include that I use this primer before I put on my foundation.
So first I want to start out with my Bobbi Brown corrector. Correctors are amazing for under eye darkness, any purpley or bluish tones. If you are lacking sleep, or if you are sick, or if you just have dark under eyes from genetics. So I just grab that with a normal concealer brush. And it's also very, very important that you put the product in the inner corner of your eyes here. So as you can see, just by looking at the comparison between my two eyes, it makes a huge, huge difference. So next I'm going to go in with my Bobbi Brown concealer. So this basically just lightens and brightens up my corrector, kind of makes it a little bit more skin tone correct because the correctors tend to be quite peachy or quite pinky toned. I don't usually use it all over my face either. I use my foundation to cover up all of my blemishes and stuff because my foundation is full coverage. Okay, so the next step is foundation. I've actually recently started doing something a little bit different that I never ever used to do. So as you guys probably know, I use Revlon Colourstay religiously. This foundation, I am yet to find one that is as just amazing as this one is. It's just like everything that I want in a foundation, basically. It's a long lasting, like you wouldn't believe. It's completely matte. I love a matte finish. It's full coverage, medium to full coverage. It's definitely buildable. So I'd say it starts off at about a medium coverage, but if you just add a little bit more in the areas that you need more coverage, then you get that full coverage effect. The only thing that I really don't like about these foundations is the color range. It's terrible. There's no like really, really yellow foundations. They're mainly very neutral or pink or slightly olivey, slightly yellow. I just really, really, really dislike that. But if I was going to wear a very light layer of foundation, I could use this on its own. But I've recently started mixing it with my Maybelline Superstay foundation, which is really, really, really yellow, which is perfect when I'm fake tanned, which is always, but it doesn't have the staying power as my Revlon one. So I use this basically as a base, and then I use this one over the top to kind of correct the color. So I do get a really flawless finish. You guys might not like a flawless finish, you might like a really natural finish, but I personally love just a nice flawless, like one colour face. And then I just use my round synthetic top kabuki brush from Sedona Lace. I have a review on these if you want to check that out, I'll link it below. And then I pretty much just buff that into my skin. So now I'm just taking that Maybelline one and I'm just going to put a slightly thinner layer over that. So So I only put a few little dots around my face because I'm not using this one to get coverage, because I got the coverage from the Revlon one. I'm literally just using this to kind of get the colour correct to my neck and the rest of my body. The next product I used is this Face of Australia Translucent Loose Powder. So I always use this translucent powder to set my foundation, just because it makes it last like 10 times longer, and I just really, really love that matte finish. And I just use a big brush like this Eco Tools bronzer brush just to apply that. I use this tiny little Sigma brush. It's perfect for under the eyes in that area. And it's really important to set your concealer, just because if you don't, then it will crease and it won't last very long at all. And if you have oily eyelids, it also helps to put just a sweep of a translucent powder or any kind of powder over your eyelids, just to help a little bit. When I go closer into the light, it looks like my face is really, really light, but when I move back, it actually does match. Okay, so now that all of my foundation stuff is done, I'm going to go in with my bronzer. I use Hoola. I have been using my Bourjois one and my Bobbi Brown one, but I'm going to use this one just because I have used it the most out of all of the other products and I swear by it. I'm going to use my Sedona Lace Angled Kabuki. I'm not really sure what it's called. Then I'm just going to run a little bit of it on my forehead just to kind of give it a little bit of a slimmer and smaller effect. A little bit on my nose just to kind of warm it up a little bit. Recently I have been wearing this blush like pretty much every single day. It is the MAC Sheer Tone Shimmer Blush in Dolly Mix, just with my normal Sigma Large Angled Contour Brush. And I'm just going to work that above where I put the contouring powder, just where I normally get red if I get flushed. And I always blend up into my temples, just around this area here. I don't know why I apply it on my temples, like not much of it, but I just blend it up there. Just because I think it looks a little bit more seamless, a little bit more natural. Now I'm going to do my brows. This is my brow routine. Heaps of you guys have been asking me to do one of these. I just thought I would do it in this video just because it is part of my everyday face routine. I'm just going to comb through my brows, get them into the shape that I mainly want them to be in, which is just straight along with this bit, and then an arch, and then straight down. Okay, so I'm going to use my Jordana Brow Eyeshadow Powder in 04 Brown. I swear by this product. It's so cheap. It's like $2 on Beauty Giant, and it's just amazing. I bought every single possible shade, and there's like 5 of them, which is only like, what, like $10, just so that I got the exact right color for my eyebrows. And I'm taking this manicure brush, just, I think it's just like an eyebrow brush. So I'm just going to apply that in a straight line, just small little straight lines. You don't want to kind of drag it, because then you get a really unnatural line. Just little feathery strokes usually work the best. And I usually just brush up. And then it's a tiny little bit in here. And then I just finished off with some mascara and lipstick. This is NYX's Black Label Lipstick in Nude, my holy grail lipstick. And the mascara is just a Maybelline, I think it's 1x1 mascara, yeah. So obviously I look quite different when I have mascara on. It pretty much transforms my whole look, I reckon, so that's why I do look weird with that foundation and makeup on and stuff like that, but that's what it's used for, I guess, right? So thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did like the video, please do like it, because that means a lot to me and I really, really appreciate it. All of the links to all of my other pages, like my Twitter, my Instagram, my Facebook page, my second YouTube channel and my Tumblr and all of that stuff is always down below, so check that out. So I will see you next week. Bye!